All right, welcome to Iberville Parish. Plaquemine's proudest right here, or the other way around. They're proudest of this guy.
Yeah.
Davon Godchaux, chow down.
Chow down, yes sir.
Good
chow
to see you.
Nice to meet you as always.
You're putting on your annual camp. This is your fifth one here?
Fifth camp. So excited to be here with the kids. Got around about 300 kids. You know, there's a lot of kids out here ready to compete, have fun, bring energy, and just these kids are the future. So I'm always so excited to come back and watch these kids grow and watch them compete.
So it's a free camp, right?
Very free, yeah. Free.
Yeah, free.
Yeah.
So this is kind of, I guess you may come back, well, maybe not even for Christmas. This is kind of like your one time a year to come back and visit. And
yeah, for sure. You know, I try to come back every year and have my free football camp, you know, give the kids, you know, Plaquemine, it ain't much to do. So I try to get the kids some inspiration, some words of wisdom, you know, things to motivate them to get out, you know, and make your foreign life, you know, whether that's the NFL player, doctor, lawyer, whatever, you know. I always tell people, man, people think, oh, I got to be an NFL player, I got to be an NFL player, especially people out here. You can be successful and not go to the NFL. What happens every time you're successful at what you do. You can be a lawyer, a doctor, you can be whatever. You don't have to go to the NFL to be successful. Graduating high school, graduating college, that's success, you know?
Yeah.
Do something after that, though. But, I mean, I tell people all the time, man, I always look forward to coming back here and doing this camp every year.
That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of different professions here.
Yeah.
I see my guy, DJ Kool-Aid, Troy.
Yeah.
He's a DJ
and a security guard.
Yeah. So you can, a lot of different ways to skin a cat and do things. So you're with the, going into your second year with the Patriots,
second
right?
Second year with the Patriots.
What was the first year with Bill Belichick like?
Love him. Great teacher, great person, you know, has the personality when people don't know. You know, has a personality behind closed doors. I love him. You know, you want to bring the best out of you. And you got a coach that want to bring the best out of you at a high level each and every day. Practice, meetings, whatever you do, weight room, you know. So, I mean, I love him for that. You know, bringing me, I had one of my best seasons last year with the New England Patriots. I look forward to another dominant season this year.
Yeah, I looked it up. I think he had 65 tackles last year, something like that.
Yeah.
And you were coming off an injury, too,
right?
Yeah,
coming off a bicep injury, yes.
Yeah. So that had to make you feel good for your confidence.
Feel good. You know, I feel like the year when I tore my bicep, the year before I had a career year with the Dolphins, 3 sacks, 75 tackles, my highest. I was second in the NFL behind Cam Hayward, you know, who's a great, hell of a player. You know, coming off that season, then my fourth year got hurt with my bicep. You know, I just feel like I was about to take that leap.
Yeah.
Like just explode. And I got hurt, you know, I never questioned God, you know, for injuries. I got hurt, you know, came in my fifth year with the Patriots and I blew it up coming off an injury, bicep injury. And you know, I'm so thankful. I'm thankful for that to stay healthy and going into my sixth season now.
And, you know, Saints fans were bummed out about winning 9 games and not going to playoffs. You guys won 10, right?
We won 10 with Mac Jones. We won 10 with a great rookie quarterback who's done a lot of great things for us. You know, I look forward to seeing his second year elite. He's so mature for a rookie last year. You know, he led our team in the offensive room specifically. You know, I'm so excited to see what he can do in year two.
You guys able to get along with the whole Alabama LSU thing?
We good. Me and Mac good. We talk trash, but Mac is like one of the most humble guys. You know, we talk trash, you know, we just like, hey, I think LSU's gonna win tonight. You know, we talk trash, stuff like that. I'm always down for my Tigers. I'm down for my Tigers, whatever, you know, whether they lose the season, you know, but we about to have winning season. No doubt in my mind, Brian Kelly's gonna bring winning football to Baton Rouge. You know, Coach O did it, you know. Brian Kelly, you know, Coach O won a natty. I think Brian Kelly gonna take it to the next level. No doubt in my mind, he's gonna put LSU back on top.
Now, you told me a while ago you haven't met Coach Kelly yet, though, right?
Never met him yet. Not besides playing against him. He beat us in the Music City Bowl. I think he beat us in another bowl game when I was at LSU. I mean, well, when I left LSU, like 2 years ago. In
Citrus Bowl.
Citrus Bowl, yeah.
So, 2017.
I mean, always the luck of the Irish.
Yeah, he joked about that. He said the weather just got cold, he said, so Notre Dame won. But, yeah, I remember that 2014 Music City Bowl.
Yeah.
We called that one the John Chavis Bowl because Chavis left right after. But, right? There's that whole distraction going in.
It's a lot of coaches do that every year.
Yeah,
they'd be already. They'd be one foot in, one foot out.
Yeah, we're not criticizing you, Coach Chavis. But I just remember
a lot of coaches be one foot in, one foot out. You know, a lot of coaches be already like taking a job before they even step into the bowl game. But you know, that's none of my concerns.
I just remember that bowl game. What Leonard ran back a kickoff like 100 yards.
Yeah, we should have kept feeding.
Yeah.
We should have kept feeding the game. I think we'd have won the game. We'd have kept feeding it.
Yeah.
We'd have kept feeding number seven. We'd have won the game.
And not to make this too much of a history lesson, but I also joke with Coach Kelly. I said, the statute of limitations has run out. Are you ready to admit that Cragthorpe scored on the fake field goal, right?
Oh, yeah.
We thought he broke the goal line, but they said no.
He definitely scored. I feel like that's a call we need back. We definitely scored on that one, definitely.
So you were recruited by Miles, right?
Yeah, Les Miles.
So this is LSU's.
Love Les Miles.
We're not going too far back, but this is LSU's third head coach since you signed with LSU, right?
Yep.
So you love Coach Miles. I mean, there's been a lot
love
of stuff
coach
out there.
I didn't have a problem with no coach, you know, at LSU. You know, I love all my coaches. You know, they treated me right. I earned everything I got there. Nothing was given. I earned everything I got. So, you know, I was, we always say, you know, like, Fair, but not equal. That was a word when I first got in the league, my D-line coach told me. We're going to be fair, but not equal. So basically, when I got in the league, I couldn't be equal to a Dominican Sue.
Yeah.
He'd been there, established. We're going to treat you fair, but not equal. You know, and I never knew what that word mean when I first got there. And I see it every day in the NFL. You know, every day. You got to earn. Every day is a proven lead. What have you done for me lately in the NFL? If you get complacent, think you done did something, then hey, you're gonna be out the door. I see a lot of guys do it today. Now a lot of guys get complacent and they out the league. Superstars too.
Well, now you've earned that spot.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's flipped.
6 years, about to be my 6 year in the league starting. Guys say the same. Six years in the NFL. Yeah.
Not that you're taking it easy, but look, you played 17 games and everything.
Yeah.
You've gotten to a point now. Okay, well, I can rest sometimes, but the rookie's gonna have to do some stuff.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. I never like to try to kill my rookies in the league. I never try to like kill them, make them like carry my pads. I never was the type of vet. They got best vet all the time. I never was the type of person to be like, hey, carry my pads after practice. Go get me this. I just ask for the small things, like, hey, can you go get some water for the room?
Yeah.
With the room need water. We just finished a little long. Like, can you get some water? I never ask. I don't believe in killing guys' pockets because we all work hard for our money.
You make him get up and sing a song, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Joke song all the time, yeah. Joke song, get some water for the room, I'm good.
Make him get up and sing like a Beyonce song or like a woman's song, you know, kind of get embarrassed him a little bit.
Water for the room, jokes, and we good. Like training camp, we need jokes.
Yeah.
Because we all tired, we all beat up. So we need jokes, we need to laugh, and we need to feel we're away from our families, you know, so we need laughter in the building.
Yeah.
It's hard enough.
So let's talk more about LSU. So D-line, okay, this is your spot, right? So apparently this is going to be a strength of LSU's team this year. Okay. I don't know how familiar you are with Jaqueline Roy and Mason Smith.
I'm so excited to watch. First of all, let me say this. I'm so excited to watch all you guys play this year. If I had a dream player for LSU, D-lineman, I love all you guys. I watch all you guys. Matter of fact, I know all you guys' names. I watch all you guys. If I had a dream, I'm going to pick this one player out. If I had a dream, I was talking to Frank Wilson the other day about this guy. If I had a dream player, body type, it'd be Mason Smith. That guy, I think all you guys, the sky's the limit for each. No lie, I think the sky's the limit for all you guys. But I think Mason Smith, I'm putting the pressure on him. I think Mason Smith could be a top 10 pick. If he believes that. And if he's practiced like that, and if he play like that.
He's only a sophomore.
Because if you practice like that, the game will be easy. You know, and if you practice like that, then the game's gonna be so much easier when you're gonna dominate. So, but I think all those guys are talented. But I think Mason Smith, that's the guy that I looked at last year and I was like, wow. Like the few games he played, I was like, wow. Like the body type, the explosiveness, the length. But all you guys can be shots in the Ali Gay, all you guys. All you guys can be something special, but you gotta believe that.
So in the concept of defensive line, we got the big tree trunks, you know, like you, like Jaqueline and Mason down there. And then you got your BJ Ojulari and your Ali Gay to come off the
Freaky up edge. Can bend, can pass rush, Ali Gay, BJ, what had like 9 sacks as a freshman.
Hey, very good.
Freaky.
Yeah.
So I mean you guys gotta take that approach though. Each and every day you guys come to practice, come to work as a group. Nobody try to do it as one. Do it as a group, and I promise you guys are going to reach the sky's the limit. It's a brotherhood. D-line for life. You believe in that. When you break down in the room, in the huddle, believe that and dominate each and every play. Stop the run. Coach always told me, stop the run, have some fun. Stop the run, you have fun. Everybody want to get sacks. Everybody want to hit the quarterback. Stop the run, have some fun. So you guys do that, I promise. The sky will be the limit for you guys this season. And it starts with the D-line and the O-line. It's not going to start with the receiver. I'm not going to start with the quarterback. It starts with the D-line and O-line. Dominate the trenches, and I promise you, you have a great football team.
Davon, it's the discipline, right?
Yeah.
It's the discipline to take the boring plays.
Yeah.
When you try to make a big play, and then that's when you leave your assignment, and then somebody wiggles loose and goes for a big gainer and all that.
You gotta know how to do it. You gotta know how to work the system. Gotta know how to when to take your shots. You know, because offensive linemen do get kind of just talking as a D lineman. Offensive linemen do get kind of greedy. They want to jump and try to you know, jump out, come get you on the pass block. You know, you got a lot to take advantage of different schemes, different types, you know, and also studying film. You know, I know you guys probably young in college. You know, I watch film, but I ain't really study film. It's the difference between watching film and studying the film.
Yeah.
Some people just watch film. Okay, so study it, break it down.
Yeah.
Like first and 10, okay. Second and 10, get back on track, you know. Third and short, you know. Might be a quarterback, actually study the film, you know, so I think once you start doing that, I mean, you guys in college, I'm not expecting you guys to really study film like that, but, you know, just be the best you, man. Just be the best you and play at the highest level. I mean, I mean, give all you got. That's all you can ask. And the most main thing and most important out of everything, be consistent. If you're not consistent in nothing you do, you won't make it. Be consistent.
Yeah. Well, not to compare what I do to what you do, but I remember when I got into television, our professors told us, stop watching television, start observing it. Like, how did they do that? How did they do this?
You dissect know? It, so, dissect it, yeah.
Yeah, facts. Break it down. Yeah. And your brotherhood did you talk about too? I mean, the Christian Lockatures, the Greg Gilmores.
Yeah, all my brothers.
Rashard Lawrence, the
all
guys
brothers,
you played with. You guys were the few in the crowd back then.
Yeah.
You didn't have the depth that these guys have,
all,
right?
Not at all. So, I mean, I was playing, 60, 70 plays a game, like body getting beat up, banged up, you know, so I mean, but you guys, man, like, it starts with the D-line. You guys believe that, you guys practice like that, dominate that practice. You can't dominate that practice, you're gonna dominate the game. Dominate that practice and the sky's gonna be the limit, I promise you.
So when you line up on an SEC Saturday and you're in Tiger Stadium or the Swamp or Jordan Hare or Tuscaloosa, Alabama, what should the defensive line's attitude and mentality be that day in terms of impacting the game?
Let's eat. Start fast. Go out there and get a sack fumble. Watch out you there, Alabama, Gainesville, watch how the crowd gonna be hype when the game starts, but watching you get a sack fumble, the crowd slow down. A big third down sack, a big first down sack, second down sack. Watch how the crowd all fumble. Whatever you do, TFL, the D-line's gonna start the game. O-line, if the offense gets the ball first, O-line, pound them in the run game, block them in the pass game. Start fast. Because that's going to get the other guys going. I promise you it will. I didn't see it happen too many times.
Well, in 2019, when LSU went over there and your old buddy Tua took off and he dropped the ball and Andre Anthony fell on it, to your point, the whole place goes quiet and everything. So, yeah, there is that mentality. And look, LSU's had so many talented players in so many different positions. To call it DBU, in my opinion, I get it, and I'm not criticizing it, but the defensive linemen that have played there and the wide receivers and the running backs. And
we need to get that. We need to get that D-line standard back to high where it needs to be at. That D-line standard needs to be back to golden, the Glenn Darcy's. I can go on and on, the Drake Nevers, the
Brockers.
Jackson, Brockers, you know, the Benny Logans, you know. We need to get that back to that standard and even better. You know, we need to get that back to where we get drafted and go to the lead and produce. And, this boy from LSU, can't forget my brother, Daniil Hunter, you know, who's an absolute monster in the league, you know. We need to get it back to that standard, that level. And I think, you know, once you take that approach in practice, you're going to do it in the game. The game, then, you know, big plays, get paid, you know. You go get drafted, then you go produce in the NFL, because if you're producing the league, you won't be that long.
Yeah.
You won't be that long. You'll be looking for a job in a minute.
Great stuff. I don't want to keep you too long, but you kept going on. I still remember the first time Daniil Hunter stepped on campus.
Yeah,
us,
my
the
guy.
Media,
I
were like, did you see that
guy?
Did you see the veins coming out of his arms and his neck?
My guy.
I think he's called him the Terminator or something.
My guy, I love D. Very humble guy. I took it all to my mentor. And Daniil, please don't get mad at me for saying this. Daniil had one suit in college.
One suit?
One suit.
Like when you walk down the hill?
Daniil had one suit. I love that about him. Because I knew right then and away when he gets to the league, he's gonna be smart with his money. Daniil had one
suit. Well, that's true.
Daniil had one suit. And I always joke with him. You know, and now look at him. He's probably a $100 million man, you know?
Yeah. Well, that goes back to Eddie Robinson and Grambling, the rule of one.
Yeah.
One car, one house,
you know?
Oh, you only can drive it one at a time, so why need multiple? So, yeah.
So, summertime right now, this is that, see, the difference between other sports is that football, the buildup is kind of all to itself, you know? Yeah. Basketball starts in the middle of football season, baseball starts in the middle of basketball season. What's this time of year like for you when all the fans are salivating, thinking about football season and playing and everything?
I'm training. I'm traveling, spending time with family, my son. But most importantly, like, just getting away from the game. Training, you know, I'm still training. You know, I love to travel.
Yeah.
But just getting away from the game, man. Just getting away from the game, just relaxing. You know, just you know, watching my film at one at a time. You know, just thinking about the game, but I'm staying away from it. You know.
Yeah.
I want to, you know, cause, like you say, it's 17 games now. It's a long season. And you got 3 preseason games still. You know, you got 3 preseason games.
Look,
you got 3. They over there, sir.
You want to pick him up real quick? I don't know if I can fit him in the shot here. What's up, man?
Say what's up to the camera, dude.
What's up, y'all? I have a little YouTube. I love time. I miss y'all very much.
You miss what, YouTube?
Classes.
Yeah, they over there on the sideline. They on the sideline.
What do we say, class of 2037?
2037. They over there, sir. They over there. They over there. They over there by the bench. Gloves by the bench.
Good stuff there. What? Well, yeah, he looks like he's already ready to make some tackles.
Yeah, he's ready. He's ready to close by some people.
Well, good deal. All right. Well, you're excited about the LSU team this year?
I'm very excited. You know, I want to see more. I want to see more on the roster. You know, I haven't really looked at it like that, but I'm excited. I'm talking to Frank Wilson yesterday. I'm excited.
Yeah, Frank Wilson. He's like a relative too, right? You've been knowing him for so long.
Yeah, he's the recruiter guy. He knows everybody. He can get it done. Right. He can get it done.
Good deal. Davon Godchaux, great talking to you.
Thank you always.
Thanks for putting this camp on.
Always.
For the kids.
Thank you.
All right.
Appreciate it, y'all.